Yes, this is the center of the universe. I was talking a little bit about the Ski Jam Oriental track, which is based on one of the most iconic presets on one of the most iconic synths in the synth history. It's the Ski Jam preset on the Korg Wave Station, which was released in 1990. And I found after digging a little bit that this Ski Jam preset is made and named after a guy called Peter Ski Schwartz. That was a sound designer for the Wave State and for Korg. I want to try to make my version of this Ski Jam. And the Ski Jam is used in a lot of action movies. I actually made a playlist with only Ski Jams. It's a one note preset where you push one note and it's instantly recognizable. So if you shazam a track with the Ski Jam preset used, you're going to get like different results every time. And it's used to death in the 90s in a lot of action films and crime films. It has like really action flavor to it. But I want to try the Wave State version on the Korg Wave State synth, which is supposed to be the Ski Jam 2.0. And it sounds a little bit like this. It's like a lot of samples that are sequenced in a wave sequence. It's really a cool one. It doesn't sound exactly like the Korg Wave Station, but it's pretty close. It's close enough. But I wanted to have it in 100 BPM, a little faster. And I also wanted to add the microtonality and the quarter notes to it. And the Wave State is one of the synths that really needs a panic button, but it doesn't have one, so we have to know how to turn off the sounds. So the Ski Jam Oriental preset also kind of reverse engineered the lead sound, which is kind of it's a little bit like this. Yeah, it's really hard to play in time with this wave sequence. Yeah. But it's not exactly like the it's not exactly like stop it. It's not exactly like the preset on the Wave Station. So for the actual track, I ended up using a Wave Station VST. Even though I really like the Wave State, since it's you can modulate and tweak around on these wave sequences and make your own and stuff, it's super nice. But they didn't nail the Ski Jam lead sound 100%. Yes, so as you can see, there is a lot of samples and stuff popping around on the synth when you play the preset. It's like 16 samples cycling around. Cool. And if you start messing around, it can end up really far out pretty quickly. The So it would be very easy to make like not only one track that is key jam, but make like kind of a whole album and just key jams. It's like kind of endless possibilities. Only this with only this cycle of samples. I really wonder how I perform the Oriental Ski Jam live. Not really sure. I think I will just run the samples and play the clarinet, because it like kind of ends up as a noise concert pretty easy. It's like stuff. By the end of the day, all music is like some version of the ski jam. I wanted a real ski jam for the video, so I ended up filming myself walking on skis for the first time since I was a child. And to be a Norwegian, I'm really, really bad at skiing. So the video turned out to be really hilarious. Actually, I made the video before making the track, but the track fit perfectly into the video after the track was mixed.